Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for coming back. It's always a pleasure to see just as many people in the second half as it is the first half. Hopefully, you've all been following the golden rule, which is the more you drink, the better we sound. Always works both ways. Hopefully the band haven't been following that rule, but we'll find out soon enough, I hope. That opener there was the main theme from Batman, the movie. It's actually the theme tune from Val Kilmer's epic portrayal of the Dark Knight. So, we're going to move on now, and again, just like to soften the mood ever so slightly. Now, I mentioned that all those years ago in 2010, my first test piece in the Northwest was the Moorside Suite. If you go back even further than that to 24 or something like that, a while back, my first test piece when I was a real nipper was The Entertainments by Gilbert Vinter. And if anyone knows the music of Gilbert Vinter, I didn't realise how lucky I was. What an introduction to the world of brass band music, one of the real masters of it. He was actually a bassoonist and fought in the army, I think in the Air Force actually, during the war. But once he left the army, he became a composer, and he's written thousands and thousands and thousands of pieces for the BBC. So if you went down to the BBC archives and had a look through, you'd be able to find thousands of pieces written by Gilbert Vinter that you've probably already heard on the TV. Now, his Entertainment Suite was originally written for the string quartet, but it made its way into the brass band idiom, and it's a beautiful, beautiful test piece. It has three movements, the Caprice, the Elegy and the March, and we're going to play what is personally my favourite movement from the suite, and that's the second movement, which is the beautiful Elegy. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now I have to waffle whilst we move the band around. So, we're going to move on to a piece. It's a new arrangement that the band have found. It's called Reach Petit. It's by... It's the Jackie Wilson classic. It's arranged by the Scottish composer and arranger, Sandy Smith. What's the Scottish composers and arrangers tonight? I can't quite figure out why. Suspicious, who knows? But it features the cornet sections in two choirs of cornets. So we have Choir A and Choir B, and it also features a fantastic horn section of Shuey, or Stephen, as he's sometimes referred to, Catherine, and Elaine. So please enjoy Jackie Wilson's Reach Petit. Yeah, they don't really need me, do they? I think the chant goes sacked in the morning. They get sacked in the morning, hopefully not. So that was Reach Petit, and it featured a wonderful horn section. So we've got another classic for you now, and it's a game. We just wanted to bring that mood down. Reach Petit gets us all up and hyper, this one, just to bring us back down to earth, a lovely, cool version of Neil Hefti's Lil Darlin. Now it's originally written for a big band that doesn't have any lyrics, but if anyone's interested in jazz music, and particularly jazz singing, there's a fantastic jazz singer known as Kurt Elling. If anyone's ever heard of him, I would urge everyone to check out his stuff. He's just the most wonderful jazz singer. and he does a brilliant vocal version of this. So if anyone of you get a spare moment tomorrow, have a look out for Kurt Elling. Really, really great singer, and loads of stuff for you to work through. But this is Philip Sparks' arrangement of Neil Hefti's classic, Lil Darling. I was just asking as well, this is a really, really quiet piece, and the band have worked really hard to make it really as excellent as we can for you. So if we can just really listen into the performance, that would be really appreciated. Thanks very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, kind of inadvertently, I've ended up with a little bit of a kind of swing section, which is always nice in a concert, I think. So who can have a swing section without a feature from Frank Sinatra? Of course. We've got a brilliant arrangement for you now by Daryl Barry. I think he's English, so that kind of breaks the Scottish streak that I was on after the rugby today. You know, I have to get as much in as I can. I don't even watch rugby, was that funny? I don't know. Okay, so this is a classic by Frank Sinatra, arranged by Daryl Barry. This is Fly Me to the Moon. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we've actually come to the end of the programme.
Oh.
As Stuart knows the crack, he knows the... Thank you. Tenors in the post. We're actually going to change it up. We play quite a few swing numbers now, but actually, we're going to go back to some of the roots of brass band playing for our finale. The brass band community owes a great debt to the Salvation Army. Have we got any Salvation Army people in tonight? Fantastic, bro, it's lovely to see it. Actually, a lot of my friends, when I went through music college, a lot of my friends were in the Salvation Army. And I think that's just because of that history and tradition they have of promoting their faith through music. So the Brass Band World owes a real debt of gratitude to the Salvation Army for the brilliant music they've provided. And actually, the test piece that we just played at our area a couple of weeks ago was written for the International Staff Band. It was the Pilgrim's Progress, and it was an absolute stonker. It was fantastic. Now, the piece we're going to play is based on Salvation Army music. It's not actually written by a Salvationist, but again, it was written for the Salvation Army Band. It was written by the composer, Paul Lovett Cooper, who I'm sure, if you've been to a brass band concert, you must have heard some of his work. He's a fantastic composer. He writes really exciting, almost filmatic music for brass band, and he treats the ensemble just beautifully in the way that he writes for the ensemble. So, we're going to finish off our piece by Paul Lovett Cooper's Fire in the Blood. So please enjoy. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. We might have one more tucked up your sleeves, that's really up to you. So please enjoy Paul Lovett Cooper's Fire in the Blood. Thank you.
behalf of everyone at both us fans club, I would like to thank Tinsel Band for giving us a superb concert. One that's covered composers or influences of the British Horn Nations, and a composer born in the Channel Islands who lives in Delft, as you heard in the last one here. I think they deserve another round of applause. We have only had one soloist tonight, but what a smashing performance we had. For a performance of Stars on Principal Cornet, put your hands together for Michelle Barrow. Next week, we have two exciting concerts with seven bands in total. Ooh! Could be a great Mother's Day present as well, I believe. First up is Mass Brass 6. That's on Saturday at Upper Mill Civic Hall, starting at 7 p.m. Our six bands will be Milra Band, Dogcross Youth and Delft Youth Band, Upper Mill and Delft Band, and of course your very own Bosa Silver Band. Tickets are £8 or £6 for concessions, and if you want to buy a ticket, maybe two or three, you can always ask our Linda behind the bar. Then on Sunday, we'll be welcoming Hazel Grove Band at the Bosa's Band Club. They're a second section band that won the third section prize in the 2020 Northwest Regional Championships. That's at 7:30 p.m. And as always, doors are open at 6:30 p.m. So please arrive early to be sure of a good seat. And unlike the Upper Mill Civic Hall one, as with all the concerts at Bosa's Band Club, pay at the door. Once again, thank you for your support. Don't forget to tell your friends about our wonderful concerts. Spread the word on your favourite social media channels. You know the ones, InstaChat, Snappagram, Facebook. Tell your friends on that Amstrad email of yours, maybe a trim phone. Better still, you can follow Bosa Silver Band on Twitter and on Facebook. Take care, stay safe, have a safe journey on. Before you all wander off, let's see if Andy's got another great piece for you. Thank you very much.
Okay, do you want one more? Yeah. Okay, now I couldn't round off a concert without something hailing from Scotland, could I? We've not had much. Now, it's a really famous piece. Has anyone ever been to a wedding in Scotland? No. You have? Yeah, brilliant. So every wedding in Scotland ends with this tune. It's of course Loch Lomond. And this is an arrangement by Andy Duncan. Andy Duncan, brilliant Scottish tuba player and composer and arranger. And it's a version by a Canadian band called Run Rig that is the end to every single party in Scotland. It's a really wonderful thing. Now, the middle section of this tune calls for a set of bagpipes. Now, I don't know if any of you ever tried to find a piper in Bosworth, but you'd have better luck finding a Morris dancer in Glasgow, I think. So, what I'm going to need to do is get you guys singing along. Do you think you can do that? Yeah. You all know the tune? Now, we'll go through the words real quick. I'll give you an authentic Scottish lesson, okay? So, I'll say it, you say it back. You'll take the high road. I mean, yeah, fair enough. 10 out of 10 for enthusiasm. I'll tack the low road. But I'll be in Scotland afore ye. Yeah, not before you, we don't speak like that up north. No. We've made it our own language. Where me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. Okay. When you get your cue, I want you singing Raising the Roof, okay? Make some noise. Okay, so this is Loch Lomond. Thank you very much. Before I finish, I just want to say a quick thank you to this band, this group of players. At the risk of sounding like a football manager or something, they've given their all over the past few weeks. They had the area competition not 2 weeks ago, and it was very, very intense. And we had to travel down to Corby, which is somewhere apparently in the Midlands. It felt like we were travelling to France at one point. And we got together, put on a great show, got a really great result. So I'm really, really chuffed with them. But not to rest on the laurels, they had one rehearsal off after the area, and we've turned this concert around in three rehearsals. So I just want to say a huge thank you to everyone. I really appreciate all the work you've done. Thank you. So now, Loch Lomond.